we have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order in which a credible United Nations can use its peacekeeping role to fulfill the promise and vision of the UN's founders.
Disagrees, then we're going to Lance, Forrest, and many others. You're on the air, Andrew.
Hey, Alex. I've been a long-time listener. Over the past year, I've really become disgusted with a lot of the things you say and do. I made a list of things, actually, if you'll give me just 1 minute to go through it. I know you like to cut people off and not let them finish.
Well, no, I will cut you. Hold on a minute. I will cut you off if something you say I said isn't true or is spun, and I will counter each of your points. But if you actually answer my questions, I'll keep you on. Go ahead.
Okay, let's start with this. I take real issue with the fact that you say you predicted 9/11. It's clear to anyone who can go and look for themselves that Bill Cooper predicted 9/11 1 month before you did.
I mean, this is what Patriot Radio covers. So, of course, other people could see the clear programming. Okay, now let's go to your next point. Go ahead.
Okay, my next point is you had Bill Cooper on your show one time.
Hold on just a minute. Hold on just a minute. Hold on a minute. This is all about patriot mythology infighting stuff. That's not what I do on my broadcast. Okay? Oh. And I know what you're going to say. You're going to say you had Bill Cooper on, and you said that you let him go because he was cussing. And then people go listen to the radio interview, and they don't hear cussing. And I appreciate your call. Have a good day. I'm not going to sit here and talk about some dead guy on my show, okay?
Let me ask you one thing. What did you think of Bill Cooper?
Well, Bill Cooper was an alcoholic. He got mad because the network put me on at night, and he thought, and I'd really, really never heard his show because I didn't listen to a lot of shortwave. I was busy. He was an egomaniac, and, you know, talking about flying saucers in the ocean, and I just feel sorry for Bill, and he really let him set him up and, you know, ran out there and helped him kill him. But anybody, I mean, he was a liar, though. You know, one time I had him on the radio, and he was cussing, and I delayed him once. Then I said, please don't cuss again. I delayed him again, and I said, okay, thank you. Bye-bye. And then he went around saying he never cussed. The guy cussed on air. He cussed at everybody. He was yelling at the board op going, you effing little idiot. You know, I told you to call this number to effing have me on.
Die, you son of a bitch. Screaming, die, die, just in a ha, ha.
I'm sick of you not listening to me!
And it would take turns beating, beating and beating, knock your teeth out, you son of a bitch!
Shut up! Scum, filth, degenerate, viperous, murdering trash! You piece of... You understand that, you little pieces of trash? You jackasses? Do you get me, you stupid piece of crap? You dumb son of a bitch? I'm sick of it! Guys, he was a pathetic drunk. And I don't like attacking people, but if you really want to know, that's it. Is that your answer? You like that answer? Anything else, sir?
I believe you. I mean, I know you're putting out a lot of truth out there, and I'll tell you the best
thing
I heard.
Look, man, some dead drunk, and I drink a few beers too, but the point is he would get falling down drunk, okay? And I was nice. He said the IRS was after him. He needed help. I call him up and I go, hey, this is Alex Jones. I'd like to interview you, get you some help from the IRS. And he goes, I've heard you, you little S-H-I-T. You don't know as much as I do. And I said, well, I'd like to have you and help you out with the IRS. Cooper.
Hello.
Yeah, that's one of my friends just called in. He's got an Apache over his house with camera pods and infrared taking film. We're going to play that on our TV show. This is just wonderful. We get followed around by unmarked police cars, openly taking 35 millimeter photographs of us. That's just wonderful, isn't it?
Well, it's just one other manifestation of the Nazi Gestapo police state, which has taken over this country.
It's just, again, I mean, I get on this program 6 days a week, and I know how you feel when I talk to you this week. And I'm 24 years old. I'm ready to just say, screw it. Because you got these people cramming cheeseburgers in their mouths, and they love it. I mean, doesn't it ever anger you?
Well, of course it does. What angers me most is the stupidity of the vast herd of American sheeple out there. They think they know something, and they don't even know what planet they're on, to tell you the truth.
No, they don't. We stopped, myself and a few others in this town, stopped the Delta Force from coming and doing secret military training and paying off our police chief. Now, the San Antonio police chief, a man that you ought to be aware of, is Al A. Philippus, and I went down and got an interview face-to-face on videotape, and I've actually played the audio here on the show several times, where he said they tried to bribe him. They were very unprofessional. They were out of their jurisdiction, and they wanted to use live ammunition. They're practicing taking over police stations.
And keep sucking more and more out of the system, through the bogus Internal Revenue Service income tax system so that they can keep from getting caught as long as possible.
Oh, but that's been reformed. It got reformed last week. Didn't you hear?
Bullshit.
Oh, boy.
Anybody that believes that is not playing with a full... In fact, they're not even playing with a deck of cards. They're playing with matchsticks.
Well, I'll never forget... President Clinton got up there on TV 6-8 months ago, or I guess a year ago now, and drew that big zero on a white piece of paper. Skyscrapers and 1,000 Cadillacs and 100 Mercedes. It's obvious to anybody that they are spending more, and they're using this to... So you think in the next 2 years... We're headed into some...
I didn't say in the next 2 years. I said in the next very few years.
Who do you think, as leaders from your intelligence networks, do you think are on the horizon? Who do you think the next president will be? Do you think?
Why do I care? They're not my leaders, and it's not my government anymore.
So the point is...
They have subverted my government, destroyed it from within, and my only hope is that I can find enough good American patriots who are moral, who are good men, who understand what liberty and freedom is all about.
Now, the federal attorney general out there, Jesus Rivera, he's saying that they're going to proceed against you with prejudice and caution. I think...
You're reading an article that you read in the Arizona Republic.
Yes, I am. The communist newspaper.
Never tells the truth. I can guarantee you that that's not what he said. I can guarantee you that what he quotes that Sheriff Arthur Lee said is not the truth. We spoke to Sheriff Arthur Lee last night. Arthur Lee says that I'm right, that he has jurisdiction over the feds in this county, and he has told them not to come in this county and harass this family.
Absolutely. Well, we've learned that with the press, that they will flat out not twist the truth, but when they need to, they will flat out lie. Flat out lie. Well, sir, I really appreciate
it. They go there, they're going to be absolutely amazed.
Well, I've been there several times, and it is a lot of good information for people to see. And I do respect you, and I certainly hope that the feds do back down, because I know that once a revolution does start in this country, and we've had a couple of them, that it's not going to be a pretty one. And that's it. The whole thing starts, and I know that I'm on the list. Thanks for being with us this evening. Again, this is all, I guess it's not good news, it's not bad news, it is just the news, and I'll be trying to keep in touch with you. God bless.
You too.
Take care. That was Bill Cooper. You can tell I'm real tired. That guy has a lot to say. I got like 3 hours sleep last night. Good thing we have good guests like that. And I've got to go down and or get somebody to let Shane Witcher in the building. He's been in Montana where they're kicking people off the land and shutting down public lands. I'm Alex Jones. This is The Real Spin. Stay with us. We've got a double up on...
Apparently somebody called the Alex Jones broadcast and asked him why he didn't have me on the air, or asked him something about me. Alex Jones said he had me on the air once before, several years ago, and had to cut me off the air because of the foul language that I used. So on the air tonight, I'm going to tell you, Alex Jones, you are a bold-faced, miserable, stinking little coward liar. I was only on the Alex Jones show one time. It was years ago. And I stayed on for the whole show. Some of you in Texas know that that's true because you heard the broadcast and you taped it. Later, when I found out who Alex Jones was and what he was doing to the truth, and what a cowardly liar and sensationalist he really is, every time he called me after that, I have always refused to appear on his broadcast. Absolutely refused to lend him any credibility whatsoever by appearing on his broadcast. And that made him very angry. I've also revealed him for the lying, sensationalist, bullshit artist that he is by every once in a while bringing to your attention the lies and the deceit and the rumors that he spreads over the airwaves that are not good for any of us, and they're not good for the nation.